Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. There's a cool feature in Photoshop CC called Perspective Warp. It allows you to change the perspective of an image in a photo. You won't find this feature in versions before CC. If you'd like to use this photo to follow along, I included its link in the video description or project files. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl-J on Windows or Command-J on a Mac. Go to Edit and Perspective Warp. You may see a small window showing you a tip on what the layout function does. Go to the corner where the sides of the castle connect. Drag out a plane over the left side of the castle. Go to a corner point and drag it so the angle of the perspective line is parallel to the edge of the castle. Drag the corner pins so the lines of the grid become parallel to the perspective of the castle. You can also use your arrow keys on your keyboard to nudge the corners. To extend any side of the perspective warp, press and hold Shift as you drag the side out. Drag another plane over the other side of the castle. When the two planes are close to one another, you'll notice that the two closest sides become blue. When you see this, release your mouse or pen, and instantly the planes automatically snap together. As before, drag the corners until the lines of the grid are parallel to the perspective of the castle. When you're done, click on the Warp mode. If you click on the vertical lines icon, it will vertically straighten all the lines of the perspective warp and the image within it. I'll click the Remove Warp icon to bring it back to its original shape. By clicking on the Horizontal Lines icon, it'll make all the angular planes horizontal. You can also opt to make all the planes both vertical and horizontal at once by clicking on this icon. Go to the line that connects the two planes, hold down the Shift key, and click on the line. Its color instantly changes to yellow. This tells us that the line is now anchoring both planes. When we click the top pin and drag it to the left or right, we can see either more of the front of the castle or more of the side. When we're happy with its perspective, click on the arrow at the top or press Enter or Return. By toggling back and forth, we can see the power of perspective warp. If you hide the original photo, you'll see that areas are missing around the outside edges. By keeping the original photo visible, it camouflages most of these areas. However, if you want, you could fill in the empty areas with Content Aware. To do this, open your Lasso tool and drag around an empty area. Then, go to Edit and Fill. Choose Content Aware and click OK. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.